What if a customer wants to pay less for an invoice that you sent them? In that case, you would have to make a credit memo. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. A credit memo is the document you would make if a customer wants a return or a refund from a previous invoice. Making the credit memo requires the exact same steps as making the invoice. It has the opposite effect of an invoice in every way. You must use the same items or the same income accounts that were on the original invoice that is being credited. So on the original invoice, when you created it at the beginning, the income went up because the invoice indicated that you earned income, and the balance of the customer in the accounts receivable records also increased by the same amount of that very same invoice. So therefore, making a credit memo must decrease the balance in accounts receivable because the customer will owe you less. And of course, if the customer owes you less, that means you actually earned less income or never really earned the income for that credit in the first place. So therefore, making the credit memo would make that very same income account decrease. Please note, you must apply the credit memo to an open invoice. Usually, credit memos are applied at the moment that you are recording receiving the payment for that invoice. So, for example, let's imagine on March 20, we gave Candy 3 video hours credit for invoice number 11 that we made for Candy back on January 21. Well, the video income will decrease because we're making a credit memo for an invoice that had video on it. And of course, Candy's balance, as well as the accounts receivable account, will decrease by the amount of that particular credit memo. And the amount in this case will be $900 because that's the money amount of 3 video hours that we are crediting. Now, of course, these are the numbers in the trial balance before you record our first credit memo. But after you record the $900 credit memo to Candy, accounts receivable will decrease by $900 and become $23,040. And video income will also decrease by that same $900 and become $47,100. And you can rewind the video to this point right after you record the credit memo to make sure your numbers and your trial balance match what you see here. So let's go ahead and record the March 20 credit memo. To do this, you open the new transaction menu. Either click on the top left where it says new, or if you don't have that, go to the top right and click the plus sign close to the cogwheel. Either one will open the same choices in the new transaction menu. We go all the way across to the customer column and we choose credit memo. Now we know the date is March 20 of 2017 in our little story. And of course, the customer is Candy. And it's 3 video hours. So we're going to put video and we're going to put 3. Now, here's the credit memo, simple as creating the invoice. And trust me, down here at the bottom, there's a save and close. I think I can squeeze that up here. Okay, and save and close. And now you can see the trial balance numbers are exactly as what we expected. After you check your trial balance, you must also check your open invoice report. You must make sure that the credit memo that you just made shows up on the open invoice report, and it should stay there until it's applied to an invoice. Now, usually credit memos get applied to invoices at the moment the invoice is paid. That's the moment the person is using the credit. So, let's imagine on March 21, Candy paid all of invoice number 12 from January 11th, and that's the moment she will use the credit. We will apply the credit at the moment that you pay, and both the credit and the invoice will disappear from the open invoice report. Let's take a look at how to record it. Now here we are in QuickBooks Online, and let's click Reports, Custom Reports, Open Invoice. And if you go to the bottom, you see the credit memo that we just created. And the only reason it's still on the open invoice report is because it has not yet been applied. Now we're going to pay March 21. We're going to pay off that invoice. So we click the plus sign. We go all the way over to receive payment. And we make the date March 21 of 2017 in our little story. The customer is Candy. And as soon as you select Candy, you will see not only all of her open invoices show up, but if you scroll down a little further, any unapplied credit memo will show up. Now what we will do is we will click this invoice and we will click this credit memo. By checking both of them in the margin, you will see that we are telling QuickBooks Online that we are paying, or at least Candy is paying, all of invoice number 12, some of which is coming from credit memo number 16. So when we scroll up here, we see that QuickBooks will assume that we will be depositing into our bank account $2,400 from Candy. And again, that's because we're telling QuickBooks all of invoice number 12 is being paid and 900 of the credit is being applied. So when we click Save and New and close this out, you can go back to the open invoice report, and what do you see? You no longer see the $900 in credit, and you also no longer see the invoice from January 11th because we told QuickBooks it has been completely paid. Now you must know how to handle credit memos in this situation. March 22nd, we gave Betty one editing hour credit, and we will decide later, or at least Betty will decide later, how to apply it and which invoice it will go to. But at the moment we create the credit memo, again, editing income will decrease by 140, and accounts receivable will also decrease by 140. Let's take a look at how to record it. So we go here, and we click the plus sign, and we go to credit memo. And again, this is March 22nd of 2017 in our little story. This time it's Betty, and we're only giving her one editing hour credit. So the amount of the credit memo, as you can see, is $140. And just like last time, when we click save and close, we can come back to the open invoice report, and we see that this $140 has not yet been applied. It simply lowers Betty's balance. Now, without paying, she wants us to apply the credit memo of $140 to invoice number 13 from March 10th. And she wants us to apply that before she pays it, and she wants to see that it was applied on the statement that we will send her, and we will discuss statements a few videos later. But right now, on March 23rd, she says, show me you're applying that $140 to invoice number 13. Well, in a case like that, you have to make something called a $0 payment. And it's really, really easy. You click the plus sign. You go to receive payment. Now, we're not really receiving a payment from Betty on March 23rd of 2017, all we're really doing is applying. But you see, it's the receive payment window that allows you to apply. So first you have to click the invoice, but if you do that, QuickBooks will assume you're paying the entire invoice. So after clicking the check mark in the margin, you then have to change the money amount to the money amount of the credit, because that's the amount you're decreasing the invoice. Then if you click the credit memo, you will see that both the credit memo and the invoice that it is applied to both say $140 and nothing else is checked, and amount received stays zero. That's all you're doing on March 23rd, because only the receive payment window can apply a credit to an invoice. Now when we click save and we close it out, you can come back to the open invoice report and see the $140 credit is gone, and you can see the invoice from March 10th has decreased to $2,100.